To add these rational expressions, we need to make sure that we have common denominators. That's the only time we can add rational expressions. Because remember, rational expressions are just fancy fractions. So if we look, we have three different denominators. But the first denominator we need to factor to get a better look of what's actually going on. So if we factor this first denominator, it's actually going to be x plus 3 times x plus 4. So now we can see better what we have and what we need to get. So the first denominator has a factor of x plus 3 and x plus 4. The second denominator just has x plus 3, and the third one just has x plus 4. So we want to use a least common denominator of x plus 3 times x plus 4. So think about what's missing in the current denominators. So in this first one, we're good. We have the LCD in the denominator. So we're not going to change the first rational expression. But the second rational expression, we need an x plus 4. We currently have x plus 3, but it's missing that x plus 4 that we need. So we're going to multiply the top and bottom by x plus 4. I'm not going to write it on the bottom because what we're going to basically have is the same denominator all the way through. So I'm not going to bother writing that every time. Then in the third rational expression, we have an x plus 4 in the denominator, but we're missing that x plus 3. So we're going to multiply this third rational expression by that missing x plus 3 on the top and bottom. But I'm going to focus on the top because the denominator is going to be the same no matter what. So I'm going to write my denominator for all three at the bottom. Then I'm going to focus on the top. So I have the 2, I'm going to just write that here. Now, plus, let's write our second numerator, x times x plus 4. Then I have plus 1 times x plus 3. So I'm just going to write plus x plus 3. So if I simplify, that's going to be 2 plus, I can distribute my x value with x plus 4. So I have x squared plus 4x, and then I have x plus 3. And all that is divided by x plus 3 times x plus 4. So now, let's continue with simplifying. We're going to add like terms. I'm going to write it in where my exponents are in descending order. So I have x squared. Then I've got 4x plus x is 5x. And then 2 plus 3 is 5. All divided by x plus 3 times x plus 4. Now, if the numerator here was factorable, you would want to factor it and see if you have any common factors to cancel out. But the numerator here is not factorable, so this will actually be our final answer. X squared plus 5x plus 5, all divided by x plus 3 times x plus 4. And there's no need to multiply the binomials in the bottom. You can just leave it as it is.